Hello! Today we're going to take a look at solving equations with variables on both sides. The solving process for these types of problems will look similar to more simple forms of solving equations. It'll just require a few additional steps. So let's start by taking a look at an example. So let's start with 5x plus 9 equals 3x minus 7. To solve problems like these, you will want to get all the variable terms on one side of the equation and all the constant terms on the other side of the equation. It doesn't matter which side either one goes on, just make sure that all the variable terms are on one side and all the constants are on the other side. So for this, I'm going to get the x terms on the left side of the equation. So to do that, we'll subtract 3x from both sides. If you wanted to subtract 5x from both sides and get the x terms on the right side of the equation, that would be totally fine as well. So 5x minus 3x is 2x. The plus 9 stays the same because we didn't do anything to it. Our 3x's cancel out on the right side and we're left with negative 7. So now to get the constants on the other side, we're going to want to subtract 9 from both sides. So we're left with 2x on the left side because our 9's cancel out. Equals negative 7 minus 9 is negative 16. And finally, to solve the equation, we need to get x by itself, so we do that by dividing both sides by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1, so we're left with 1x, or just x, equals negative 16 divided by 2 is negative 8. So x equals negative 8. Let's take a look at another problem. Negative 2x plus 13 equals 6x minus 31. This time, we're going to solve for the variable on the right side. So to do this, we're going to start by adding 2x to both sides of the equation. That will get our x terms on the right side. So our 2x's cancel out over here, and we're left with 13 equals 6x plus 2x is 8x. Minus 31. Now we want to get our constants on the left side, so we'll add 31 to both sides. 13 plus 31 is 44. So we have 44 equals, our 31's cancel out, so equals 8x. And finally, to get x by itself, we divide both sides by 8. 8 divided by 8 is 1, or 1x, so we're left with x on this side. And then we can leave this as a fraction, 44 over 8. Now this fraction isn't in most simplest form, so the best thing to do is to simplify it. The way that we can simplify this fraction is by dividing both the numerator and denominator by 4. So when we do that, we'll leave our x alone over here. 44 divided by 4 is 11, and 8 divided by 4 is 2. So x is equal to 11 over 2. Let's take a look at one more problem before we go. 4x plus 17 is equal to negative 9x minus 9. So first, we're going to add 9x to both sides. If you wanted to subtract 4x from both sides and solve for x on the right side of the equation, that would totally be acceptable as well. The reason I chose to add 9x to both sides is because I don't particularly like working with negative numbers when I don't have to. So I'm adding 9x so that I'll have a positive number of x's on the left side. So that's why I chose that, but if you like negatives and want to do that, you're more than welcome to. So 4x plus 9x is 13x. Plus 17 equals negative 9. Now I'm going to subtract 17 from both sides of our equation. So we have 13x equals negative 9 minus 17 is negative 26. So notice we have a negative over here, so we're dealing with negatives anyways. So it's just up to you back at this first step if you want to have negative x values or negative constants. Either way will get you the right answer. So to get x by itself and solve for x, we're going to divide by 13 on both sides. 13 divided by 13 is 1. 1x is just x. And negative 26 divided by 13 is negative 2. So x is equal to negative 2. I hope that this video gave you more confidence in solving equations. Thanks for watching and happy studying!